What's up, everybody? This is the Jedi. I wanted to put this at the beginning. I've already finished the video, so I know it's an hour and a half long now. But I wanted to put this at the beginning for a couple of reasons, because the first of which, in the video, I represented to you that I was going to be bringing you several topics, not just this piece on Monique. But I ended up spending more time on this necessarily than I had anticipated or even imagined, quite frankly. I'm doing, once again, one of my analytical breakdowns of this appearance by Monique on The View from yesterday. And as is characteristic of my many gifts, but certainly with analytical breakdown is something that is definitely a forte for the Jedi. So I've put together something here that is going to leave you highly enriched. I can take any topic, or what I try to do with any topic that I bring is I try to give you a complete education on not only that, but any tentacles or extending pieces, things you can walk away with and use in your everyday life from the moment the video is over. You're not able to put all that in a description of a video. You simply can't. But one of my gifts is to be able to take anything. You give me something, you give me a video, you give me an article, you give me anything. You put a person in front of me, and I can extrapolate things out of that will give you more insight and more vision than what is directly in front of you. But I also do this for the purpose of teaching my people and inspiring my people to look deeper and listen deeper, to watch, to observe, to use the faculties that God has given you. But you also have to have knowledge converging. This is why it's important that you educate yourself across a wide range of topic and interest, so that, and you see those as pieces of a puzzle. Your knowledge is puzzle pieces, and your overall intellectual footprint and your representation of yourself intellectually is how well are you able to now pull pieces of your intellect to make a complete picture, puzzle, or thought after you've been presented with any experience, situation, or person. And this is something that I'm very good at. So no matter what anybody else is going to say about this appearance by Monique on The View, you simply won't hear it the way you're going to hear it from the Jedi. So settle in, and I'll see you soon. What's up, everybody? This is the Jedi. Monique appeared on The View yesterday, apparently. And I've made some observations that I think I would like to share with you. You know, initially this video, the video I was preparing to bring you next, was an Inside the Money on this Black Panther movie, because, you know, we're hearing these numbers, it's breaking box office records, and it's, you know, and it's making this and it's making that, and a few of us have speculated about what the main principles are making, like, you know, the main characters, you know. But at some point we should be asking ourselves, where does the rest of all that fucking money go? Where does it go? Who does it go to? Who gets the money? Because we just see premieres and red carpets and the movie and, you know, Ryan Coogler in an interview and Chadwick in an interview and, oh my God, is that Michael? You know, and but where's the fucking money going? Whose house do I need to show up at to get a check? You see, who's really getting the money? It's like in the music industry, you know, Celine Dion can sing "My Heart Will Go On" until her face breaks, but the writer. As wealthy as Celine Dion is, and she's a very wealthy woman, it's the fucking writer, bitches. It's the writer. And then that also is subject to contracts and, you know, how astute and savvy was the writer. You know, did you just go and sell a song? Oh, here's a song I'm selling, and then that was just a base rate, and then that just got a sh kind of got sold, shopped around, and then they present, oh, we think this would be a good song for Celine, and then they give it to her, and oh my God, it becomes a $100 kabillion song. And then what was in the contract? You know, as a business person, I'd like to look at the contracts and the fine print. Do you get some sort of do you have guaranteed money coming to you once it becomes a $100 kabillion song and it's in Titanic and oh my God, the whole world knows the lyric to it? So this is all important, you know, because I've already expressed my disdain and disgust about the fact that we don't own the movie. So we're not getting that money. We're not getting that money, you know, and shout out to my girl Valtressa because, you know, God bless you, but like we talked about, you know, no, unfortunately, no, that money from them actors don't go into the black community. Because when's the last time you saw any of them at your local Waffle House that we don't even own anyway, you know, or your local anything, or ooh, down the street from me is a plaza that Chadwick built, or it used to just anybody, you know. But I liken it, I've compared it to the NBA players and the NFL players. There's hundreds of billions of dollars out there just amongst they fake asses. And we don't see any of them. We don't know where they live, and we definitely don't see their fucking money. So I'm gonna be breaking that down in this damn video. And the other thing that's got my ass on fire is while we're, because I always look for the look away. When it's, ooh, look over here, look at the something shiny, look at something shiny, look, it's shiny. While everybody else looking at the shiny shit, I'm always looking to the left to see what's over there that's not shining. And I'm gonna bring you the left moment in this video while everybody's looking at Black Panther. Ooh, shiny, shiny, you see? But this is the thing that has my ass in a bunch right now because Monique was on The View, and this f whore that's on your screen right now, this buck-tooth whore, fuck Whoopi Goldberg. Like everything inside of me wants to respect her. She's had a very long career and all of that. But fuck her. First of all, look at our queen. She could not look more demure. Look at Monique. She looks fantastic. 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 As a matter of fact, she came out there and put all those bitches to shame, if you ask me. Every bitch up there has got a summons, just received a summons. Just received a summons the moment she walked out. Except for maybe Sunny Houston, because that is my girl. But, and we're going to hear a little bit of this, but I want to say why I'm bringing this is because her ass. Because of fucking Whoopi Goldberg. First of all, the bitch's name is Karen Johnson, so let's just call her Karen. All right? Fuck that Whoopi bullshit. The bitch's name is Karen. All right? That's her government name. Karen Johnson, bitches. So, normally when you have a walk-on, and they honored her by giving her a walk-on. In television, you don't always get a walk-on. Now, sometimes you have a big star, and the only reason why they won't, or even just a guest in general. But it's a sign of honor and it's a bigger deal in television if you get what is known as a walk-on. Like literally, you walk on. You know, sometimes you don't get it because maybe the interest of time, like they're running out of time, a segment ran too long, and oh my God, we didn't get to I don't know, Demi Moore or some bitch. I don't know. Anyway, and then they go, please welcome Demi Moore. And then she's already sitting there, so you don't get a chance to see them walk on. All right. So in this case, she had a walk on. And, but after the whore introduces her, the moment she sits down, you normally get the moderator and the hosts and everybody. They always say, "Hi, how's everything? Maybe some pleasantries. Love your outfit. How is everything? Good to have you on the show." None of that happened. Hear how this was now. Hear this. Hear this. Wait, let me cue it up. And look how this whore treated the situation.
Is calling for a boycott of Netflix for gender and racial discrimination, saying she was offered a fraction of what other comics are being paid by the streaming network for comedy specials. Now she's here to share her story with us today, so please welcome.
Wait, first of all, let's go back, because everything matters. I always tell you, everything in television matters, everybody. Even when they look like they're just being incidental and whimsical, fuck that. There is none of that. Throw that out of your existence. Look how she reads this. First of all, she's reading it as if she doesn't know Monique personally. That's first of all. That's a problem. And then she's reading it as if the details that she's reading are something completely foreign to her. As if she, like, she does the same thing when she reads literally something that's foreign to her. Like, I've seen her when she's reading the teleprompter and it's about some overseas event or some person whose name she's not familiar with. She's doing the exact same thing with this. But this is on purpose. She's aware of the subject matter, and she's aware of the individual, and she has personal knowledge and communication with Monique. So in that context now, rewatch this.
Comedian Monique is calling for
Wait.
So when an actor, comedian Monique is calling for a boycott of Netflix for gender and racial discrimination, saying she was offered a fraction of what other comics are being paid by the streaming network
The hands.
comedy specials. Now she's here to share her story with
There,
us
look at
today.
the eyes,
So
the
please
hands.
welcome.
Like as if it's this kid that we just plucked from New York. We found him in the Bronx on YouTube, and I'm reading a little bit of bio on him, and we're going to come out and we're going to meet him for the first time. That was the whole flavor of that, everybody, because you must understand, Whoopi Goldberg has every fucking award that they give out. She has the Oscar, the Grammy, the Emmy, and the Golden Globe. And she's been in a million movies, and she's a $20 million actress, and I'm over it. But I offer her resume to you to say this, to say to you that she's an industry insider. You understand? Like, this is someone who has the type of influence, if you will, because we're careful of the word power, because at last she's still a slave ass bitch. So we're careful of this word power, and I think even with Oprah we should use the word influence. You see, power is something else, because power is associated with being a, with it's different than influence. Influence is I can walk into a Denny's and I'm the Jedi, so they're gonna tell me I gotta stand and wait. Why do I use Denny's? I don't even fucking eat at Denny's. Anyways, damn it, it'll be in the book. Anyway, so at Denny's, I walk in and I stand there. And there, you know, there's four other people, there's six other families in front of you, you know, whatever. Okay. Now, I'm Oprah and I walk in. They're going to get me a table immediately, even at fucking Denny's. And those eight families are going to stand outside while I'm being seated. That's influence. That's different than power. You see, power in this same scenario would be I can, like I can run Denny's. And it's not, still not the, it doesn't say it as clearly as I'm trying to communicate it to you. But I'm trying to use the same example so I can show you the difference in power and influence. I'll just say it like this. Power, I can make you do something. Influence, just my presence and my gravitas and my reputation makes you do certain things. That doesn't mean I have any power over you. It's just you're inclined of your own will to do something that you otherwise wouldn't do based on perceived impressions about me. Hopefully that makes sense to you and it wasn't too intellectual. Now, so this whore wields a lot of influence. And even on The View, you watch her and she's a bully. Like everybody else kind of puts themselves together to come out on the show and they show up and they've got on something nice basically. And she always comes out there looking like the fucking cave bitch that was just rescued from some fucking island. And I'm over all the little fucking shoes she wears and shit. The bitch has gray hair. I don't like the way that she deflects any and all things that have to do with the real issues of African people. She always minimizes it and then includes everybody else, like as if our shit is part of one sandwich, when our shit is separate and apart from the whole fucking buffet. You see? And so she's an insider, and it's important to discuss that in this context because the Monique is coming out. And we've seen her be way more excited about other comics specifically than she is about Monique. 'Cause remember, she's a comic, Whoopi Goldberg. That's where she started her bread and butter is in comedy. You see, now she's this bully bitch. Every time she opens her mouth, she talks over everybody on The View. They're afraid to talk. She decides who's going to talk and how long they're going to talk and all the shit. And she's only there. Here's the last thing I'm going to say before we play this. She's only there, everybody. You don't get to look like that. She's not Halle Berry. She's not my wife, Janet Jackson. She's not a what their white society would call a good-looking woman. I don't think she's ugly, just personally. Like my critique of her is not about her looks, but I'm adding this to give you something to say that because based to add to give my point more weight. She's not there because she's beautiful. You see? She's not there because she's beautiful. She's there because she's the black face that's not Star Jones, because Star Jones ain't gonna go along to get along. She did to some degree, but at the end of the day, she got more hood sister in her than this bitch right here. You see? Same thing could be said about Sherry Shepherd. But this is a go along to get along bitch, and she's a get for them because she's been given all the awards, and she's been given those awards not because she's brilliant, but because she knows how to play the game behind the scenes. She's never going to sell out to the white devil. And she was married to a white devil, Ted Danson, back in the day, who put on blackface and it was a big scandal. Fuck her. This bitch, fuck her. She's not one of us. We don't accept her as our own, and she is other. Now, observe this again. And then watch how she goes directly. Monique hasn't even finished sitting down yet, and she already starts pelleting her with questions. No pleasantries. Not how you doing, or give her a chance to say hello to the panel. None of that. Watch this shit, and it's a walk-on.
Oscar-winning actor and comedian Monique is calling for a boycott of Netflix for gender and racial discrimination, saying she was offered a fraction of what other comics are being paid by the streaming network for comedy specials. Now she's here to share her story with us today. So please welcome the fabulous Monique.
Monique looks divine. Divine. Let's just see that walk again, y'all. Just the walk.
Fabulous Monique.
Just the walk. Divine. That's what black girl magic and motion looks like. Do you understand me? Strong. Now watch, watch. She's not even finished. The music is still playing. The crowd is still going.
Netflix offered you half a mil.
Directly into the questioning. No, how you doing? How was your flight? How nothing? No, bitch. No, so now Netflix did such and such. You see? But then now watch how she's so now when in the introduction she was reading as if it was some new alien species that she was introducing and she had no idea what the subject matter was. Now look at the body language now as she's talking about the actual meat and potatoes of the situation.
So, Mo, Netflix offered you a half a
Look,
mil
finger and
on the
everything.
special.
N remember, the hands were open before now. When you put your finger, when you put your pointing finger on your baby finger, as like this is number one, this is number two, and you start going down fingers, that means it's personal to you. Do you understand? That means you're itemizing. You see, like number one, you see, that's that subconscious speaking through the body language, everybody.
Yes. Netflix
Watch, watch her
offered
hand.
you a
Look at
half.
that. You see that? Watch the finger.
So, Mo, Netflix offered.
Look at that. Look at this. You see? That means there's already an agenda, everybody. There's already an agenda. There's already an agenda. This is number one. When she first comes out, hit her with this. And this bitch is so ready to get to it and do Massa's bidding that she hasn't even allowed for the ladies on the panel to even greet Monique. You know, and for her to say, "Hi, everybody, thank you for having me on the show." You know, usually the guests will come and they will say to the audience or something, you know, "Hi, everybody," and you know, whatever. None of that happened here. And then you look at the hand right there. This is number one, bitch. We ready for you. You see? We may not get to the other stuff, you guys, because I didn't know I was going to get this forensic with it, but here we go. Here we go.
You half a mil for a comedy special.
Yes.
They reportedly gave Amy Schumer 13 mil.
Yes.
Is your issue that Netflix?
Now, here's one of those questions. This only comes from white people. Black people don't ask questions like this, everybody. This is so important. This is so important. Whatever you're doing, stop it and focus on this. This, hear this now. This is not a question. Like the way the question is laid out, the cadence of the question is not, and the way it's structured, this is not the way African people ask questions. This is a patronizing question. It's like, let me help you understand it in your where you sit and breathe. Your boyfriend or your husband or your wife comes home and you're the fucking cheater. You're the wrongdoer. And then you give this question, which again, as Africans, we would never do this, but I'm trying to help you understand their thinking and how they do shit and those who work for them and carry their water like this whore. So, you're the wrongdoer, you're the cheater, and your wife comes home and you go, "So, what is your issue that I was wearing a suit or was it that it was," it's like you dance around the issue like, "Oh, it could be anything. I don't know. Maybe I had a finger in my ass. Maybe aliens landed on my nose. I mean, I don't know what it is." You know, it's kind of in that area. So is your issue that, you know, that I was, that I'm a man? Is it that you are a woman? Are you just mad that there's oxygen on Earth? Is there a, I don't know, is there something about rockets in space? I don't know, you know, it's that. No, motherfucker, then you would slap him in his fucking face, say, "No, bitch, you know exactly what the fuck it is, and you know the bitch it was with it, woo, 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 woo." You see? So listen to the structure of this question as if she has no clue what your issue is, and that's to minimize your issue. That would make me go over and pull her throat out, do you understand? And be ready to take the jail time. Don't fucking patronize me and don't minimize my shit. But it's also a testimony to the strength of this woman. To me, the patience, the demeanor, whether you want to agree with Monique or not, I don't care. The demeanor that she has displayed throughout this whole thing, everybody, has been on par for me. What I saw in the patience and demeanor exhibited by Barack Obama. I'd never seen a more patient human being or more controlled, self-disciplined human being in my life. I promise you. Because I understand the enemy, the environment, and the condition, and I saw 8 years this brother not so much as stutter. It was just. Like, I can't. Like, I would have already been in jail, like, first month in office for killing every fucking body on fucking Capitol Hill for pissing me the fuck off. Every white devil. But he didn't do that. And he was able to even keep his wife secured. You feel me? Because Michelle will cut a bitch. Understand that. So I offer that because Monique is grace under fire. I said that in the last video I did about her. To not just go off, she's contained. She's cool, and in that space, she's able to be quicker on her feet because when you get emotional, you can't think. And she's able to contain. Wow. To me, that's what makes you a force of nature. That's what makes you a force, because I'm a very emotional person, and passionate, and they're not the same thing, you know. Emotion is one thing, passion is something else. And you know, emotion is just a feeling. Passion makes you get off your ass and go do something about it. So they're two separate things, you know. And wow. I couldn't, like, I'm telling, I got to tell the same story, and I know what I'm up against, and I'm just one voice in a big pond, and you feel like the weight of the world is on you, and nobody's going to really hear your message and believe what you're saying, and you a sister girl at the same time. I don't give a fuck what you want to say about this woman. She, to me, goes down with Mary McLeod Bethune and Harriet Tubman and, goddamn it, Michelle Obama and anybody else you're going to fucking name. Just for her demeanor alone of being grace under fire. Wow. Wow. So now, watch. She starts battering her with questions immediately. No pleasantries. Everybody else has already taken their seat. Monique is still sitting down, and so is the whore. The fucking transient whore. You see what I'm saying? She's got money. She could do a better job of dressing than this. Just, even if it's not her desire, just to represent your people. You feel me? And to just represent black women in general, you know. But as a man, I want to be represented too, whether you are a man or are women. You see what I'm saying? So can't you do something better than that? I'm over it. Now, she has sat down. Everybody is seated now. Their guest is the only one still standing. She's not even gotten comfortable in her chair. So, Mo.
Netflix offered you $500,000 for a comedy special.
Yes.
They reportedly gave Amy Schumer $13 million.
Yes.
Is your issue that Netflix offered Amy more than you, or that you feel they're discriminating?
See the squinting, and like I have no idea what this is. Is it that they offer Amy more than you, or you feel like this is she's they've talked about this on the show, everybody. She knows what the issue is.
Offered Amy more than
Well,
you,
let's hear that. I
or
want to
that
be clear you hear
thirteen
this.
mil?
Yes.
They reportedly gave Amy Schumer $13 million.
Yes.
Is your issue that
Wait, wait,
Netflix
wait, wait, wait,
offered
wait.
Amy for a comedy special?
Yes.
Wait, we have to go back.
Oh, Mo. Netflix offered. Netflix offered you $500,000 for a comedy special.
Yes.
They reportedly gave Amy Schumer $13 million.
Now, right there, she's looking because she has to remember not to mention Chris Rock and Dave Chappelle. She went directly to Amy Schumer and is just going to try and protract and shrink the issue to just that, when we all know it's not just fucking Amy Schumer. It's about Chris Rock and Dave Chappelle too. None of these people does Monique have any beef with. She's just saying, I'm mad at they got a steak, but you supposed to be putting steak on my fucking plate too, bitches. Where's my steak? You said all I got is a boiled egg over here. But this whore, she's reading now again, but this isn't the same reading like she was doing at the beginning. This is to keep her on track. She only mentions Amy Schumer. And then goes into that bullshit ass questioning that I just gave you an example of. Is it just that it's a woman thing? Is it that she got more? Was it, you know, like as if I'm, was it the hair on my ass? What was it? You know. Here we go.
Yes. Is your issue that Netflix offered Amy more than you, or that
Amy, more than you?
you feel they're discriminating?
You feel they're discriminating? The hesitation before she said discriminating because she don't like to even use that. Because massa don't like to hear that.
Against women,
or women of color.
Women or women of color, like just, but put the women before women of color always.
What exactly?
Like, what exactly? You know, in other words, you just brought me a formula for space that I've never seen ever on Earth, and I don't understand even the hieroglyphics that the formula is written in, and tell me what this is. You like, it's as if it's that foreign to this bitch that's been in the fucking industry for 1,000 years, and fuck her, dude. What is the issue? So, and also, she's not offering her any sister girlness right there. There's a way she could have put that if that was her sister. You see? There's a way she could have did that to let her sister know, I got you. I got you. I feel you. I understand you. I hear you. But none of that's taking place. It's the, what formula is this for calculus?
Offered Amy more than you, or that you feel they're discriminating against women or women of color? What exactly?
Well, the issue was when I first said, let's boycott Netflix.
Now, we all know Monique's side of the story, so I don't really think I need to bore you with her side of it again. Because she tells it the same way every single time, because I can tell you the truth don't change. It don't change. If it rain on your house today and you take a picture of your roof, when it rain next year, your roof gonna look exactly the fucking same, because that rain and the truth is the same thing. It's gonna look the same fucking way. So let's go to this other slut, Miss Joy Behar.
And then we'll come back to you guys.
But Monique, when she sold out two full houses at Madison.
Now, just to introduce what she's saying so you understand why the fucking Roadrunner is even speaking, is because Monique was just saying how that, you know, the part of the story where she talks about how they claim they gave Amy Schumer the amount of money they gave her because she had sold out Madison Square Garden twice and she was in a big summer movie. And, you know, that part of the story. So she just finished telling that, and then this is what fucking Joy comes in to say.
We'll meet with the team, and then we'll come back to you guys.
But Monique, when she sold out two full houses at Madison Square Garden, that means the girl can pull. It's all about asses in the seats.
I totally agree with you.
You know what I mean? So that's not her resume. That's what she drew.
Yes, I totally agree with you.
And then Monique, very gracious. She never loses her cool. I bet you she ain't even got no armpit sweat going on, y'all. She's that cool. She's that graceful under fire. And respectful to a fault. She goes, yes, I agree with you. And then she delivers her hammer.
And when you look at the resume of Monique, that's ass is in the
See? So she shut her down. And that's like one comic to another one. Like, stay in your place, white bitch. Stay in your place. Stay in your place. So she very kindly, with a feather, slit her throat. You feel me? And let us not forget, everybody wants to go straight to the queens of comedy. That's fine. But there's more to the resume than that. You must understand, Precious was an Oscar-winning fucking film. That's asses in the seat. So don't give me, you see, you know, you have to have reason to go out and see somebody. If I just drive past a comedy show or something, I don't know the comic, I keep going. I'm more inclined to stop if I know who they are. So if they have a series on television, like Monique had several seasons of The Parkers, which is still in syndication right now. She's on fucking TV right now, bitches. You see, The Parkers is still on. So she had that. Plus, she had the comedy tours, and she had Precious, and she's had movies that she's been in, you know, and that her and Sydney have produced. So, I know more about her resume than I know about fucking Amy Schumer's fake ass. Can I just put that out there? No shade. So, she thought she was coming through with something else, but wait now, the slave is gonna try and back her up though in a minute. Monique just shot her down. Let's hear that exchange again.
And when you look at the resume of Monique.
Wait.
and then we'll come back to you guys.
But Monique, when she sold out two full houses at Madison Square Garden, that means the girl can pull. It's all about asses in the seat.
I totally agree with you.
You know what I mean? So that's not her resume. That's what she drew.
Yes, I totally agree with you. And when you look at the resume of Monique, that's asses in the seat.
And then she goes, well, yeah, but that's the point. Well, if we agree, then why'd you bring that up? Because you were so ready to, their whole thing, her and Whoopi have been ordained to attack Monique when she shows up, to try and discredit her, you see? And so she's so zealous to bring that, bitch, you didn't think about my resume before you made that statement to me. Monique's got some asses in the seats too, and them asses was in them seats, and them seats was warm way before fucking Amy Schumer's ass was even known to humanity. But again, she's grace under fire. Let's go on. Well, they're one and the same. Like, it's semantics. So then it's not about the resume; it's about the people you draw. Well. That's the fucking resume. Whatever you want to call it, how are you going to classify what I've done? If you want to call it anything, it doesn't matter what word you use. We know we're talking about the same fucking thing. This is the shit I've done. Because if it wasn't about the resume, then I should be able to walk into Netflix today and go, I'm funny, give me a fucking network show. Then the first thing they're going to say is, we don't know you, and what have you done? So don't give me, it's not about the resume bullshit. Fuck you, Joy, you whore. I pray for the death of people at night, y'all. You don't understand. Like, I really do. I need you to understand this. I'm seriously about who I am. Like, I pray for the deaths of people. I do. Because we always think of you only supposed to pray for people in a good light and all that. I be asking God to wipe people the fuck out. As long as they study evil and mayhem on the earth, I ask God to please, can you please kill these people off? Can you just wipe them out? Take them. Oh, my God. I'm not going to get worked up in this video, y'all. I'm not going to do it.
Because what happens is...
Wait, I want to get to the whore now. Let me make sure that she's not saying something we haven't heard.
The finish line keeps changing. And when I say that, Whoopi, as a black woman in Hollywood...
See, she puts it... You see how she looked directly at Whoopi? She goes, our finish line keeps changing. And then she addresses Whoopi directly. And looks at her. Watch this now. After she has now dropped an atom bomb on fucking Joy's rat ass. See, she gets the last word. She goes, but it is also about the resume. And now she goes in and says this.
And when I say that, Whoopi, as a black woman in Hollywood.
See, she was talking to Joy. She goes, I say that, and why I say that, Whoopi, is because as a black woman, like, here's your rope, sister girl. You was bullshit when I walked out, but here's your chance to be on a par and on the same page as me. Are you with me? Because we should be able to agree on this. Your old gray-haired ass has been this longer than me. Are you with me here? Are you with me? That's what she's saying. Once you see this whole exchange, I'm going to show you what the fucking dinosaur says back to her.
That's ass is in the seat.
The
point is, but it is also about the resume. Because what happens is, our finish line keeps changing. And when I say that, Whoopi, as a black woman in Hollywood, see, initially you're told, build up your resume. And that's what'll get the money. Then you build up your resume. And then they'll say, well, you know what? We see the resume, but we'll get them the next time.
You see the look on her face? Body language is everything, everybody. She's looking like she's in fucking calculus class and she's hearing these fucking problems for the first time in her life. Look at the whore. That's not a look of concern. Because if anything, it should be a look of testify. You see? Testify, but it's not. She's looking at her like, I see what you're saying.
Resume. And that's what'll get the money. Then you build up your resume. And then they'll say, well, you know what? We see the resume, but we'll get them the next time. And you never meet your next time. So when it comes to Netflix, and with Amy Schumer and Dave Chappelle and Chris Rock, and let me say this, what they got, they were supposed to. Mm-hmm. I don't have an issue with my sister Amy, nor my brother.
My sister Amy. Grace under fire, because I couldn't have been a set up there. Y'all know I can't even get through a fucking video call without calling a white bitch. Feel me? Like, I ain't gonna be up there with my sister Amy. But I'm not Grace under fire. So I'm saying, I'm the Jedi, goddammit. So I'm saying, I come in with blazing swords and pistols and shit. I'm ready to tear this shit up. Goddammit, kill everybody. There'll be no prisoners. I don't got the room to carry their ass. I'm over it. You feel what I'm saying? But she's so gracious, y'all. I'm telling you, brothers. First of all, think about this. I want to interject this because it's a teachable moment. We're handling one subject, but there's always a teachable moment. That's why my videos are so long, because there's always an opportunity to share additional information and knowledge. You don't have to just stay on the fucking topic all the goddamn time. So I want to impart this to my brothers and my sisters. A, for my brothers. A sister that handles herself like this under this much pressure. This is Hollywood we talking about. These are the image makers. They influence society and all the shit. This woman is in a firestorm. I need you to be clear about this. This is not like you worked at Walmart and some bitch got you fired and, you know, you got to go up to the job and all that. No. This, you have no idea of what she's under right here. I need you to feel that. I need you to feel that. Now, in that context, brothers, a woman who can put up with this shit and be this graceful in the hot light of misunderstanding and deliberate attack on her, trying to mischaracterize what she's dealing with, if she can handle herself like that, that's the perfect woman. Period. Because your ass ain't gonna have a chance to pull no shit, because she will cut your ass very kindly. You understand? But she don't need to raise her voice. She doesn't need to become unkempt. She can slay your ass with her grace. Do you understand? This is a study in patience and self-control. And to my women, you take away from this woman a part of that same message. Wow. I saw how Monique is conducting herself during this whole campaign, and she is under the foot of the fucking giant. And nobody's marching in the streets for her. There is no hashtag I'm Monique. It's hashtag me too and all the bullshit, but that's for white bitches. I already told my sisters that ain't for you. That ain't for you. That's not for you. Otherwise, this would be an outrage in the context of everything that's going on with Me Too right now. They would say, well, in the context of Me Too, how could we dare allow this to be happening to Monique? You see? The hypocrisy. The hypocrisy. So you need to see this woman and say, damn, if Monique can handle herself with that much grace, I can get rid of that tacky-ass nigga that ain't doing a fucking thing for me. And yes, I can stand on my throne as a woman, and I don't need to compromise a fucking thing. I don't need to do that. I don't need to. I'm so proud of her. I'm so proud of her.
She was my sister Amy, nor my brother Dave and Chris. But when the vice president...
Now, I want to get to... Oh, but this is important to know.
Netflix says to my husband and our attorney, by the way, Monique is a legend too. Uh-huh. Well, if I'm a legend, why wouldn't I get what the legends are getting?
Uh-huh. Okay. That's not the part. But anyway, she mentions that Dave Chappelle, Wanda Sykes, Chris Rock, and I think Amy Schumer all have the same agent. They have the same representation. So why is that I'm not getting? You feel me? Or to, however she said, I'll let her say it.
Because you said you can fill those seats.
I know that are they underestimate the power of the black dollar. The black dollar. We see that in our movies, in the theaters that we're given.
Black
we
Panther,
see that
right now.
And it's, well, we
raking
see that,
it in, yeah.
And it's raking it in. And the question I would say is, that's not something that we don't do. Mm-hmm.
our movie.
That's one of the and I was so surprised to hear this part because I was already planning to bring you a breakdown on the money in when it comes to these big ass fucking blockbuster films, particularly related to Black Panther. And so funny that she's mentioning it, you know what I mean? But that's proof right there that we've been putting butts in the seat. We can sell. I already told you, black, our blah, I can't talk this morning, y'all. I've already told you that our brand is international, everybody. Everybody on planet Earth has drawn, is drawing, has been influenced, is influenced by us. There's that word influence again, because we ain't got no power. Is influenced by us. They wearing all of our shit. They talking like us. They walking like us. They listen to our music. They go see our movies. They want everything. You see? Because we have influence. Influence, but not power. Hear this.
We do that when we're giving the proper opportunities.
Okay.
So when it comes to Netflix, and I have to go back to it, when you tell me that you are a legend, and we do know that Monique is great and Monique is funny, then how do you offer me $12.5 million than you offer Amy Schumer?
She meant to say less.
$19.5 million. But you offer two men that you say are legends. Right. Yes.
And thankfully the fucking cricket filled in for her, so we're gonna give her like a half of a point for that, but we still hate the bitch.
We have to say that in a statement to ABC, Netflix,
fuck her, we don't need to hear shit she has. Well, it's important because of what Monique's gonna say after what she says.
Netflix says that they don't discuss contract negotiations. But that being said, Wanda Sykes actually came out in support of you, saying that Netflix offered her even half of what they offered you. So what was your reaction when you found that out?
Well, let me say this with Netflix, because they said they can't comment because they're in the middle of negotiations. There are no negotiations. Netflix came back and said, pretty much, you take it a little.
And also, I gotta point this out, y'all. I gotta take license. It's my video. When you do your damn video, you do how the fuck you wanna do it. This is the Jedi. Now, look at our sister. I told you she was serving subpoenas when she came up on the damn panel, because she served every bitch up there a goddamn notice just with her presence. But look at her. And she's wearing her gray edges. You feel me? You feel me? I hope you can see and feel what I'm telling you. I will come with my gray edges. Like, I'm not trying to run from how old I am, but I can still punish you with my beauty. Punishing bitches, do you understand? Punishing bitches, punishing, punishing. You understand? You must be punished.
Believe it, that's what it is, and we're not willing to negotiate it. When Wanda Sykes came out, I applauded that. And I understand why oftentimes you don't be the first one to come out.
Yeah.
Because it can be a scary place.
Look.
But then when you know that Wanda Sykes is with the same agent as Dave Chappelle, as Chris Rock, as Amy Schumer, why was Wanda Sykes the only one offered $250,000?
Boom. Atom bomb drop. Shots fired, bitches. Shots fired. You see? Again, truth. Truth, everybody. You always hear, I speak so much about truth because I've told you a million times, truth is the most important thing to me on the earth. It's everything for me. I just, man, when I die, I want them put on my headstone, truth. 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 Write it down, truth. And look at that word every day. Look at it. What does that mean to you? What is your relationship to that? What is your relationship to that? Why I'm bringing that now is because all she is telling is the truth. And this is also an observation, a reminder, and a study in what this white man, this white devil's relationship is to the truth. There is no relationship. They are devoid of the truth, and in fact have a visceral reaction to the truth. You're not allowed to speak it, represent it, or live it in their society. You're not. They want to be able to do evil, and then you're not allowed to speak about their evil. We see that even here on fucking YouTube. You want to talk about makeup or fucking anything. I don't give a fuck. Whatever. You talk about that all day long. The moment you want to tell the truth about their white ass, they have a problem. That's why you got to be over their white ass and tell your truth. Not your truth, the truth. Because remember, truth is devoid of feelings and opinions. It just fucking is. You understand? You don't get an opinion about the sky. It just is. It just is. And you don't have to like it. And that needs to be a relationship to the truth. Live it. Tell it. You understand? And even Joy had to say that's very suspicious. I want you to hear that. Now suddenly they don't have a lot of time. Because she's dropped the biggest bomb, and that always happens on white devil American television. Watch any program, any news program or any talk show, everybody. The moment you drop major truth, because everything she's telling is the truth, and it's already a problem for them to have her up there, but they brought up there to attack her and discredit her. But she dropped an undisputable truth there. And there was a moment of television silence, and then Joy had to say, well, that's very suspicious. She had to say something. Because again, the truth is undeniable. It's like the rain. You can't deny it. You can't. Now, we don't have much time. See? Suddenly we don't have much time. You see that on CNN, MSNBC, Fox, all the time. The moment they go to that place of undeniable truth, where now you've got to answer this. Well, we're almost out of time, but I just want to get to so-and-so. We're almost out of time. I want to make sure I get to Brad on the panel and da-da-da-da-da. It's consistent, everybody. I don't watch television for the same reasons as you or the same way that you do. And I'm here to inspire you to watch television differently. Consume it differently. You analyze it. Don't let it program you. You see what I'm saying? You walk into a math class, you just start opening your book and hear what the fucking instructor is telling you. I'm analyzing the fucking instructor. Who is this motherfucker? Who is he? What's he wearing? What do I think of him? Is he qualified to be standing there teaching me? I've always been analytical like that. What is the source of anything? Why is this? How is this? Whatever it is. Who and how and why is this right now that's in front of me? What is it? And when you begin to do that, then you see these patterns that I'm expressing to you in this piece about television. You see? Again, the Jedi. Because everybody will talk about this, will just talk about what I've gone into even thus far in this piece. You see what I'm saying? But that's just all part of my gift. No shade to nobody else. That's just my gift. It's just my gift. You see? So, now we're almost out of time. She goes, now this is a more unpleasant question, but I want to get to this because this is their major atom bomb that they were wanting to drop on her. They got to make sure they get that in. See how she looked to make sure she's got time, and I'm sure there's a producer off camera going, yeah, go, 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 you're good. You see, Monique just drops her atom bomb. Let me let you hear this segment. I'm going to try and shut up, but Monique drops her bomb, and then watch this.
Why was Wanda Sykes the only one offered $250,000?
So what do you say to that?
She had to bring out the scandal. And she had to make sure she mentions troublemaker. Because television is all about buzzwords, everybody. Buzzwords. That's how things sink into the lexicon. This is why everybody that you know on planet Earth right now, well, in this bitch, not on planet Earth, just in this asshole of Satan. Go and watch anything now after you've been exposed to this, because I've mentioned this to you before. Anybody you ask a question, the soon as you finish the question, the first words come out of their mouth is, so, so. That's only come up in the last year and a half, 2 years. I've watched it develop. I've watched it. I've watched it. Do you understand? That's why I'm qualified to speak on it. It is the truth. It's not the truth or the opinion of the Jedi. It is the truth. What the white devil would call empirical truth. You see? It's the truth. So. You see? And also this word amazing. That's been out for many years now. But I watched its pathology as well. Everything's suddenly amazing. 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 You see? And then also, sort of, is another. These are all buzzwords. Buzzwords to get the society all speaking the same way. But you know that they've all been influenced by the same source. And those are just words. But they also, they don't just take words, but they also do that with concepts. Trains of thought, philosophy, reaction, what you're supposed to say and think about anything. Do you understand me? So that's what you need to understand. So now the buzzword here is difficult. You're a bit of a troublemaker. Blah, blah, blah. And we're almost out of time, remember.
Say thank you for letting me speak on it. And 8 years ago.
And then Monique says, thank you for letting me speak on it.
Oh, I did a movie called Precious. Mm-hmm. And
but now the whore is going to try and cut her off. But she goes, no, let me finish. Let me answer. You'll see. She goes, 8 years ago, I did a movie called Precious, and the whole audience went berserk. And then the cricket goes, you were quite brilliant then. She goes, thank you, baby. You see, again, ever grace under fire. Ever grace. Ever grace.
And on that film, I received $50,000, and that was not my argument nor my fight, because that's what I signed up for. Once I did all my obligations, my deal was with a man named Lee Daniels. I did all of my contractual obligations.
Shade, a man named Lee Daniels, not director Lee Daniels, a man named Lee Daniels. Grace under fire! Grace! 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 Oh my God, this is so delicious, y'all. I would be there to kiss her feet when she came off that damn stage. I would take her heels off and kiss her feet and say, I love you, my queen. I love you. I love you, and is there anything else I can do for you?
All of my obligations. My deal was with a man named Lee Daniels. I did all of my contractual obligations, and I was done. Then when I start getting calls from Lee Daniels, Tyler Perry, Oprah Winfrey.
Oh, you just said the big O. Now we're definitely out of time.
And Lionsgate. And they wanted me to come work for free. They wanted what? To go over to Cannes and promote this film internationally. And I said to them, I said, guys, my deal is with Lee Daniels. And I've done my job. And they all agreed. And this is what happens, in my humble opinion, when you don't go up to the hotel room.
Now, right there. She goes, and this is what happens, in my humble opinion, when you don't go up to the hotel room. She just made the connection between what she's out here on a life raft by herself dealing with and the Titanic that is hashtag me too. And we're supposed to feel sorry for every white bitch that's ever been looked at in a lustful way and blah, 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 blah. You see? But now she just married it to that. And remember, your struggle can never be valid. No, black people, you don't have man, woman, or child. You don't have no issue. We won't even hear of it. So now the whore has to come in. Let's hear this. Let's hear the lead into that again.
And this is what happens, in my humble opinion, when you don't go up to the hotel room. See, when I think about those women...
Now, see there? Okay. Wait, I'm going to stop you and look at the finger and the look. Like, how dare you get on Massa's legitimate cause like that? How dare you, black bitch? You could be causing me. You going to get me in trouble with Massa. You going to cause Massa to beat me. I can't. Oh my God, I can't. But look, but do I lie? Do I lie, y'all? Stop the video now when I lie. Stop the video when I lie. Stop the video and walk out the room when I lie. I don't need to make shit up. I tell you, the truth is strong enough to stand on its own. It does not need nobody. We all need it. You understand? And truth represents the Most High. You can't call yourself righteous and God-loving and God-fearing and all that shit if you don't have the proper relationship with the truth. Because one of the attributes of the Most High is truth. Contemplate that when you claim that you say filled, sanctified, anointed, baptized, and filled.
When you don't go up to the hotel room. See, when I think about those women.
When I think about those women, she just dropped the bomb. Now, somebody's telling the whore in her ear, or in the sign, there's a producer off camera waving at Whoopi, wait, get in there.
I'm gonna stop you.
I'm gonna get you. You see, the witch's brew and all of it. Ooh, look at her. She's fully invested in this because she has just dared to connect herself to the legitimate cause of lily white women. How dare this black bitch who's been wronged? You see what I'm saying? I'm gonna stop you.
Because contractually.
And she always has that look and those hands whenever she remember, in every episode of The View, she's always the one who has the ultimate knowledge on anything. She's always the one looking for the applause line from the audience and all of this. So contractually. And so now it's like I've been in the business for 100,000 years and I'm Whoopi Goldberg and I have all the awards. And so now I'm going to school you. But Monique is ready for her ass. Because what? She is grace under fire, bitches. Know this. I'm going to stop you.
Because contractually, yes. When you make a movie, regardless of who you sign the deal with, yes, your job is to go and promote said movie. Yes.
But she's already wrong. Because Monique already said, I had a contract with a man named Lee Daniels, and I had already fulfilled my contract with him. She's on television, and Monique is, you know, she understands media and television, and she understands time, so you can't, in television, like, it'd be difficult for me to be on television because I'm so long-winded and I have to tell everything, but Monique understands that abbreviation that you must acquire when you're on television, and so she's already said in that answer that. Then when I start getting calls from Oprah and Tyler and all these fucking people, you know, she's saying to you, I don't have a contract with these people, so I'm not obligated to give them the fucking thing. So, but now throw that out according to the witch's brew right here, because she's saying you're obligated to fulfill those contracts. And then Monique could have came back and said, no, bitch, didn't I just tell you that my contract was a man named Lee Daniels? But again, she's grace under fire. She's not the Jedi. Let's go on.
Sign the deal with? Yes. Your job. Mm-hmm.
Wait.
The deal with? Yes.
Wait.
Your job. I'm going to stop. Okay. Because contractually, yes, when you make a movie, regardless of who you sign the deal with, yes.
She's saying regardless of who you sign the deal with. No, everybody. Listen, one of the reasons why I own a business and I'm a business major and all that shit is because you couldn't beat me in my business law class in fucking college. God damn it. If you ever have a lawsuit, bring it to the Jedi first. I will tell if you got a fucking suit or not. Listen, contracts, again, you always get the white devil with his. We don't make no rules and laws in this bitch. So you got to master their rules and laws. And that's how you beat them at their own game. But you got to have knowledge. You see? So that's an erroneous statement that she just said. Because Monique could have said, well, then how about this? You go out now, even though your deal, when you did Color Purple or Ghost or all the other shit you've done, or Jumpin' Jack Flash and all of it, now, Lionsgate's going to call you up. They want you to go promote Black Panther. No contract, but they want your ass out there. What are you going to say, Whoopi? Well, they don't have a contract with me, will say the fucking witch's brew. You see, contracts are everything in this country, everybody. They can be verbal, and they can be written. But there's also implied. You see? But what they all have in common that nullifies any of them is if there's not a meeting of the mind. So if you were insane when you signed a contract, any magistrate or judge will throw that out. Or if you can prove to a magistrate or a judge at the conflict of a contract to say, and it's plausible and reasonable what you're saying, that that's not how I understood this contract, that also makes a contract voidable and you throw that out. You see? But in this case, parties too. So her deal was with Lee Daniels, and the way she's told the story, it was a very casual thing. It was like a boyfriend-girlfriend thing, like, you know, he's gay, so girl, let me tell you such and such, honey, and, you know, whatever, and I want you, bitch, I want you in this movie, and poo-poo-poo. All right, daddy, I'll be in it, you know, and it was just like a black thing. Yeah, I'll go help my brother out. Not when White Massa called me, and now he wants to be party to this contract, this agreement between Lee Daniels and I, because nobody else was on the phone and nobody else was a part of the negotiation when she agreed with Lee Daniels. Oprah wasn't there. Tyler wasn't there. None of these other fucking people were there. And you don't get to be party to a contract. You see, you don't just become party to unless you are agent of. What does that mean? So I own Wonder Bread or DirecTV. My technician comes out and ruins your tile on your roof or some shit. And he goes, well, I didn't have nothing to do with it. I'm not DirecTV. I'm just an agent. I'm just here. I'm just the installer. No. You're their agent. So now I get to sue him and DirecTV. Him and, because they're the entity and he's their agent, period. So unless you're going to put a piece of paper in front of me that says Lee Daniels acting as the agent of whatever Miramax, IMAX, MGM, Paramount, somebody, they're not party to a fucking contract. In other words, you try to stick your nose in where the fuck it don't belong, set your ass down. You see? So Whoopi is just wrong, factually, legally, and morally. Fuck her.
When you make a movie, regardless of who you sign,
regardless, not regardless.
Is to go and promote said movie.
Yes.
But Monique already did that anyway. So if you want to throw out everything I just told you about contracts, the fact of the matter is, she had already fulfilled that obligation anyway. That doesn't mean you just promote it into infinity and they can call you up in 50 years and go, we want you to go and re-promote the movie. Now, give me a break. You see? So she's still wrong on all fronts. So Monique's like, yeah, you're right.
No, but... So when they wanted you to come, and we've had this conversation, and I said if you had called me, I could have schooled you.
I'm a grown-ass woman. You don't school me, bitch. You don't school me. You could have said, I could have helped you out, I could have guided you, you know, and you're on, this is on international television, everybody. I could have schooled you. Think about that. I hope the bitch falls down a flight of stairs today. Today. Do you understand? Today. Today. I could have schooled you.
No, don't applaud.
Because, like, in other words, I gotta, like when other kids, ooh, you in trouble. No, don't say nothing. Because I'm about to do, so-and-so about to get their ass beat. You see? And the adults tell you, don't be yelling and pointing and all this. Nah. So it was that same thing. No, don't applaud. Because, like, this is serious. I could have schooled you.
They wanted you to come. And we've had this conversation. Yes, and I said, if you had called me.
Now, she had to say, and we've had this conversation because she knows what she's about to say. And knows how she's looking down because she's picking her word. But she mentions, we've talked about this because what she's about to say is about to be insulting to everybody that's going to hear it. Everybody that's going to hear it is going to know, fuck you, Whoopi. But she goes, no, and we've talked about this. That's to get you ready for the blow while I diss her in front of you. That's what that's about. Hear this exchange again now.
So when they wanted you to come, and we've had this conversation, yes, mm-hmm. and I said if you had called me, mm-hmm. I could have schooled you mm-hmm. on what was expected.
And when we did have that conversation, and what I
said, notice how she looked, the look when she said expected, the same way she looked when she goes, I'm going to stop you there. I'm going to stop you. Same look. I'm going to see if I can freeze it when she says it.
Schooled you mm-hmm. on what was expected.
See there? It's so quick. You got to see it. Just look at it.
I wanted you to come, and we've had this conversation. Yes, mm-hmm. And I said if you had called me, mm-hmm. I could have schooled you mm-hmm. on what was expected.
And when we did see have there? That conversation, and what I said to you, my sweet sister, I said.
And when we did have that conversation, I said to you, my sweet sister. not you, creep keeper, creep. I can't say it. Not you, creep keeper ass bitch, fucking warlock ass demon bitch. And what I said to you, my sweet sister, when we had that conversation.
On what was expected.
And when we did have that conversation, and what I said to you, my sweet sister, I said, Whoopi, at what point did we stop saying the next time? Because what was expected.
Wait now. She's challenged. And I said to you, at what point do we start saying, what did she just say? Damn it.
Whoopi, at what point did we stop saying the next time?
At what point did we stop saying the next time? Now, there's only way she's supposed to shut up and let Monique continue talking, or she's got to say, you're right, my sister. Because remember, on top of all this, we're in this hashtag Me Too bullshit, everybody, huh? And victims of school shootings and all of it. But we're not supposed to show this sister no respect? According to the White Devil and their devilish ass minions like fucking Whoopi Goldberg, no. It's too much. She's now being put under the fire.
I said, Whoopi, at what point do we stop saying the next time? Because I want to answer it.
What? See, she's personally offended because she's carrying the water for Massa. Listen, everybody, if it's me and a brother, all right? Got to use two brothers because we're both male and we both black. So we can't even use a sister for this. But a sister could be this, but you could use a sister too. That's why it's important you got to have a black woman and a black man together. You can't have a white bitch or anybody else because nobody can understand each other the same way we can. But we just don't use a brother and a brother. If I say to another brother, man, I'm trying to give you an analogy. In other words, you're supposed to see some things that we absolutely agree on. Like there would be no daylight between us on that issue because we are brothers. We are black men. There's some things that there can be no daylight between us on because it's just what? The truth. The truth. Look at the word again. You wrote it down. Look at it again. So there's some things there should be no daylight between us on. And then you extrapolate that into or expand that into there's some things that are common amongst our people as a group that there cannot be daylight between us on. And when there is, that means somebody is fucked up. Somebody is fucked up. So there should be no daylight between them on this issue. Unless somebody... is fucked up. You see? Nothing for you to do but agree with your sister. And I've seen many of these episodes of The View where she sits her fucking crip keep her ass there and don't say shit. And it just be the other girls talking. But you notice, nobody up there has hardly said anything. It's her ass. It's her ass. Fuck her and all bitches like her.
And when we did have that conversation and what I said to you, my sweet sister, I said, Whoopi, at what point do we stop saying the next time? Because what was expected.
Wait,
but I want to answer it, though.
Yeah.
I want to answer when you said contractual.
She goes, but I want to answer it, though. I want to answer it, though. And then she used her own body language to stop her.
Wait, but I want to answer it, though.
Yeah.
I want to answer when you said
contractual. She put her finger up, but I want to answer it, though. Now, she has to let her answer because Monique has not raised her voice. She's not been unkind. She's been very demure. Ha 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 ha. And so if she doesn't let her finish, she doesn't just shut the fuck up, then it will be more exposed by the less intellectual that she's there attacking Monique. So she has to shut up. Monique says, I'd have to explain. I have to explain.
I get paid for the publicity.
Yes, ma'am.
Because if I had done something for the publicity.
Wait.
Because what was expected? But I want to answer it, though.
Yeah,
I want to answer. When you said
you
want to
get paid for the publicity.
And then Sunny, who I do like, and she was a federal prosecutor, so she's obviously a lawyer. She's saying, she's just bringing the legal part. She's saying you want to get paid for your, I forget what word she used. You want to get paid to do the publicity. She's just clarifying Monique's point, helping her out, actually giving her a little bit of sister girlness. You see?
Because if I had done something wrong contractually, they would have sued me.
Boom, another atom bomb dropped. So three ways she just killed Whoopi's fucking tirade of pablum vomit. I already gave you the legal. Then I gave you that she had already completed it with Lee Daniels. Now, this third one, if she had done anything unkempt or illegal, they would have fucking sued her ass. Boom. Another bomb dropped. You see? So she's thrown an atom device on fucking Whoopi. She's thrown atom devices on fucking Joy. Sonny just came in with the legal piece just to help the sister out. You see? And then the little white heifer that walks out like a hermit, she came just with the statement from fucking Netflix, which Monique shot that down. The sister's prepared, you understand? And she's grace under fire. And she stands on the rock of truth. You're not going to get her to squirm. You're not.
The reason why no one could do anything to me contractually, because they found out I did nothing wrong contractually. So when they asked me to come overseas to promote the film, When I said, guys, I'm spending time with my family, I'm going to pass. Mm-hmm. Now, when I make the statement, this is what happens when you don't go to the room. Mm-hmm. What Tyler Perry showed me.
Now, she brought it back. She goes, this is what happens when you don't go to the room. Because remember when she first brought up the hotel room, I'm going to stop you. But now Monique has very graciously come right back to that. This is what happens when you don't go to the room. Oh, she's masterful, I'm telling you. Oh, my God. Oh my God. But this is what happens, everybody, in your life when you represent just the truth and from the space of truth. Hear that. When you represent truth and from the space of truth. You're not just representing it because you have to. You represent it because you love it. And you have the proper relationship to it. You understand? Then you get what the fake Christians call anointing, which they have no idea what that is or how to spell it or what it looks like, or no relationship to it. But this is what an anointing looks like. And I'm talking about like, oh, you're an anointed, like some hocus pocus. Woo. It's when God gives you what you see being displayed here. Her protection is there. Her protection is there. She's bulletproof. Bulletproof because her intentions are pure. Because of who she is. You understand what her character is. You don't just get in a heartbeat like that. I'm anointed. No, bitch. Go set your ass down and anoint your ass. It's who she is. You get that over time. But you don't get it if you don't have the proper relationship to the truth. Because if you don't have the proper relationship to the truth, you don't have the proper relationship to God. Period. At the end. You don't get the dog without the poop. She brought it right back.
When I said, guys, I'm spending time with my family, I'm going to pass. Mm-hmm. Now, when I make the statement, this is what happens when you don't go to the room. Mm-hmm.
To the room.
What Tyler Perry showed me, Lee Daniels.
She's naming them again. She named them again. That's twice she's indicted them.
Lionsgate. When you don't do
it. And Lionsgate, bitches. You see?
Oprah Winfrey and Lionsgate. When you don't do what we...
I gotta go back. We gotta hear it again.
Don't go to the room. Mm-hmm. What Tyler Perry showed me, Lee Daniels, mm-hmm. Oprah Winfrey, and Lionsgate. when you don't do what we ask you to do, we'll take your livelihood. So for 8 years, my family...
This is an international show, everybody. I don't know what the viewership is for The View. But she was able to, in the silence of, because every moment on television is worth money. But with no interruption, she was able to bring it completely home. She's been making a complete indictment throughout this interview. Consistent. And this is now the crescendo. Once again, she's been able to name those three people once again. Again, and Lionsgate, and put it clear to you to say this is why. This is going on. And so anything you hear about Monique, this is why. This is why. You see? And you don't ever hear them say, well, we'll have to have them on to get both sides of the story and you know, see what the situation is because, you know, we just know. They didn't say none of that shit. Because it doesn't, it doesn't have a leg to stand on.
Livelihood. So for eight years, my family has suffered. And my career has suffered because what I would not allow those entities to do was bully me. And because I didn't allow the bullying to happen, this is now what I sit in. Okay.
Yeah. See there? And then her and Joy. You heard Joy too. I don't know if you could hear it. I hope you could. We have to go. She just told you, in case it wasn't clear, for 8 years, these people, I've named them by name. I've told you what they've done. They have interfered with my livelihood. And so what's unspoken, but what is left on the heart, I'm sure she hopes, and I get it, is you should walk away from here feeling the same way about what they're doing to me as you say you feel about them white bitches that had their titty hanging out when they went up to see Harvey Weinstein or whoever. There's no difference in me and them. I wouldn't go in the room. I wouldn't go to the hotel room. I won't play their game. I won't work for free. I won't bow to their influence. There's that word again. And so for 8 years, this is what they've done to me. I'm no different than the actress that wouldn't stay, go up to the hotel room with that writer or that producer or whatever. You see? And she got no mention of what women suffer and all the bullshit that we always hear. None of that ever came up. This is an 8.5 minute interview. 8.5 minutes is a very long time on TV, everybody. It's a long time. Not one word, and they just go away. Well, we have to go. Fuck Whoopi Goldberg and the bitch that gave birth to her, and I hope she falls down a flight of stairs, and Joy Behar, they can all eat a fucking dick. I don't give a fuck.
Because what I would not allow those entities to do was bully me.
And then she used the word bully. She's her own best PR campaign, everybody. This is what the fucking big people behind the scenes that are image makers and tell you what you should say and what a press release should sound like and how you should respond to charges and scandals and shit. Monique is her own best advocate. She's using all the right buzzwords, all the right catchphrases, and she's able to lay it out in a pathological way from start to finish that anybody can understand it. So anybody leaving this goes, no, they fucked with Monique. Monique wasn't a problem. It was Oprah's ass. It was Tyler's ass. It was that fake-ass, sissy-ass, fucked-up Lee Daniels. You see what I'm saying? Grace and beauty under fire. Grace and beauty under fire. You understand? Grace, beauty, femininity under fire. Grace, beauty, femininity, black girl magic under fire. Yes.
Because I didn't allow the bullying to happen.
And look, I don't know if you can see the bottom of your screen, but you see the hand of caution is already over here. They're already like, we gotta go.
This is now what I sit in.
Okay, we have to go.
Yeah. Shoot.
That's all? When I've heard her at the end of segments before they go to commercial, she's telling Donald Trump some bullshit. She's like, so I'm just saying, what you need to do about this issue is such and such and such and such. We gotta go. We'll be right back. But all she got is shoot. Not Oprah Winfrey, Tyler Perry, Lee Daniels, you're wrong. You need to be doing something about this. It's wrong what you guys did to Monique and such a, and we'll be back. Because she's a coon-ass bitch. And the last point I'm going to make about this, because y'all know I don't ever miss no opportunity to bring this through. This is all y'all black Christian folks. You don't know God, so you don't fear him. You think he's your friend. You think he came as a man, think he had a son and all that stuff. So your character is going to be vastly different. Vastly different. And your relationship to the truth is going to be vastly different, if not completely devoid. Because you don't know who God is. Because when you know him, you fear him. And what fear looks like is you're too afraid to do your brother or sister wrong. You're too afraid to tell them something or do something that's unkempt or tell a lie or be malicious or anything. You can't. Because you understand you're going to meet him one day. And he's going to judge you. And that you don't have no guaranteed ticket to fucking heaven. There's a little chateau called hell that is eternal, bitches. Eternal. I never hear Christians talk about hell. Because everybody thinks they're going to be in some fucking heaven. You're not. You're not. Every single one of us has an appointment with the grave. An appointment with the grave. And part of what that means is you're going to meet your maker. Christ ain't died for no fucking body but himself. Just like you're going to die for your own ass. So, if you had a Muslim sitting there, their fear of God, known as taqwa, fear of Allah and the last day, you're not going to get just shoot. And you wouldn't even be sitting up there to begin with. Because that's the arena of devils. You see? That's the arena of devils. That's why you don't see a lot of Muslims in theater and all this kind of shit. Because that's the arena of devils. That's where you dwell. That's where the Christian dwells. Because they're without God. Without him. Without him. Because in the heart of the Muslim and the righteous, and certainly in Muslim countries, righteousness is the order of the day. We gotta do this because it's right. That's it. Now, in this country, well, the law says, fuck that. What's right? But they're not interested in that. And that's why they write their laws the way that they do, while proclaim themselves to be a Judeo-Christian country. It all makes my point. You see? It all makes my point. So, a Christian to another Christian. Godless folks. No character. You ever want to do business? You ever want a good doctor? You ever want a good anybody that you really need to depend on them being honest? You're going to find you a Muslim, homie. You're going to find you a Muslim because it's the only way you get a guarantee. You see? And then you want to put them through this paces to make sure they're really a Muslim. Because if they're really a Muslim, you got the guarantee. It's that simple. It's that simple. It's that simple. Unfortunately, Christians are not like that. Always after gain, what's in it for them, etc., etc. You see, I've said till I'm blue in the face, if we as African people, if you can't be bothered to be a Muslim and accept the truth of the revelation from your Lord, which is the Quran, and accept that the last prophet sent to all mankind was Muhammad ibn Abdullah, then the least you could do, the least we could do as Africans, is conduct ourselves the way that Muslims do. Because there's a code by which we operate. There's a devotion by which we are bound to one another. Do you understand? You're the ones who they mean when they say black on black crime, even. It's forbidden for another Muslim to strike another Muslim. Forbidden by God. Forbidden by God. forbidden by God. What forbids you from striking your brother or your sister, huh? What? Nothing. Nothing. Why'd you hit the brother? Why'd you hit that sister? Because they made me mad. Really? See, no code for your life. No code. No code. No code. All while going to church and praise dancing and giving your money to the fake ass Christian pastor and all of it and thinking you having some holy experience that you are not having. Because you don't have holiness where it doesn't exist. Nobody ever came out of the shower and somebody said, where were you at? Oh, I was at Disneyland. I go, but your bitch ass just came out the shower. What the fuck? If you go to Disneyland, you got to go to California or fucking Florida. Take your ass. You'd be considered psychotic. So this is another display of black Christians. This is what they do. I don't even know if she even believes in God, which is another attribute of Christians, quite frankly. You see what I'm saying? It's sad. Shoot. That's all she had to say at the end. That's all. I hope the internet drags her ass for fucking filth. Do you understand me? Drags her to dust. But she's sitting up there and she, I don't know how old Whoopi is. I think she's in her 60s. But like most Christians, like all Christians, certainly, you know, maybe you could almost get it if she was 19 or 20 or even 30. It still would be improper, but one could make the argument. But you sit up there with gray hair and everything. You have an appointment with the grave, and this is still how you act. Because Christians will act like this till they last fucking breath. Because they think they're absolutely going to heaven. And you will have a rude awakening on the great day. A rude awakening. A rude awakening. A rude awakening. A rude awakening. I leave it here. This is the Jedi.